The planet is an amazing body. Wherever you look at it, you find records of its history. And to decipher that history is one of the major challenges of the Earth sciences. Our major first discovery was to find that the gravity field of the Earth was much more complex than had been understood up to then, and that it bore a direct relationship with plate tectonics, the movements on the Earth's surface. My next step was really to look at other geophysical observations that would help us interpret that gravity field. During the ice ages, these large ice sheets, they stressed the Earth very significantly, and the Earth deformed. When the ice sheets melted, the Earth started to relax and started to rebound. That rebound process is still going on today. The surface of the planet is constantly going up and down. It is being torn apart, it's being pushed back together again on different timescales. And that's what I refer to as the breathing of the planet. Some of the benefits are going to be in driverless vehicles. You need to keep them on the road. And if the road is shifting in your reference frame, then you're going to be in trouble. So you need to correct for that. It's important for precision farming, for the soil preservation. It's important for engineering projects, mining operations. Winning the Prime Minister's Prize for Science is a great honor. It's a great distinction. I'm obviously pleased to have been recognized for my work, but I'm also pleased that my field of research has been recognized. It's an important field. What I love most about being a scientist is learning new things on almost a daily basis, but also discovering new parts of the planet. It's a constant challenge.